back to my channel. Thank you guys so much for stopping by. If you are new, hey, welcome. My name is Shantanique and this is my YouTube. If you haven't already, stop what you're doing and hit the subscribe button. Also, make sure you turn on the notification bell. I upload videos 3 times a week on Tuesdays, Fridays, and Sundays at 4, so make sure you tune in. Also, be sure to follow me on Instagram at Shantanique. I love to talk to you guys over there. I post cool things on my stories and surveys and just behind the scenes footage that doesn't necessarily make the vlog or the video. So make sure you follow me on Instagram. Today, I wanted to sit and film a really, I don't know, it's like a controversial, not necessarily controversial, but it's like an emotional topic for some people, especially right now with everything that we're going through. A lot of people are having a hard time dealing with being single or reverting to old relationships that weren't necessarily the safest or healthiest relationships. I don't know how I feel talking about this topic publicly, but I don't know, it has to be done. As you can tell by the title, I have 10 tips to help you get over your ex and move on. Because listen, sis, an ex is a non-factor, okay? They don't matter, they're not important, they shouldn't be in your circle, at least most exes, okay? Most exes. And you know, you just have to glow up and move on. I came up with a list of, don't y'all see Demi? Ain't she the cutest? I miss her so much. I came up with a list of 10 things or 10 ways to help you get over your ex. I felt like this would be a cool girl talk topic. I haven't done a girl talk in a while, so I hope that you guys enjoy. This is going to be in no particular order, but my suggestion, the first thing you should do is make the decision. If you're in a relationship with someone, especially if you've been in a relationship with someone for a really long time, you have to consciously decide that you don't want to be in a relationship anymore. We all know as women, the idea kind of floats around like, do I really want to be with this person? Like, am I really going to be with this person? Do I really want to be in this? But you actually have to consciously say, I'm over this. I'm done with this shit. I don't want you. You don't want me. This not working. I don't trust you. I don't feel the same. Whatever the issue is, you have to consciously say, okay, you know what? I'm not doing this shit with you. I'm not doing it. No. It's over. You have to decide. And if you're still kind of on the fence, like some days you want to be with the person, other days you don't, take time to really think about it, really analyze it, and decide what you want to do. Pull the trigger, make the choice. You got to do it. The second thing that I would recommend for women specifically is cry. Get it out. You don't have to be just a hardcore woman, okay? You don't have to cry publicly or you don't have to cry to them, but go in your room, cry, take a shower, cry in the shower, cry in the tub, cry in the car. Do whatever you have to do or cry wherever you need to cry to get it out. Because so many times women hold on to emotions. We kind of ball things up and try to keep them inside instead of getting it out and letting it go. That generally helps you cope and move forward. Cry, girl, cry. If you can, cry to yourself. Don't go crying to nobody else, but cry. It's fine to cry. It's okay to cry, okay? Everybody cry. Don't act like you don't cry. Everybody cry. Number 3. Now, this is a big one, and this might be hard for some people depending on, you know, where you live, where your ex lives, where y'all frequent, what friends y'all have. I would strongly suggest that you cease all communication, okay? Stop all communication. Don't talk to him. Don't let him talk to you. You don't have to be petty and block someone from calling you, but if you don't have enough self-control to not answer or not respond, maybe you should block them. When I'm broken up with you and I'm done with you, don't talk to me, okay? I don't want to talk to you. I don't want you talking to me. I don't even want you contacting me. Don't call me. Don't text me. Don't FaceTime me. Don't email me. Dudes done got real creative with the little email thing. No. Cut it off. Like I said, if you're not strong-willed enough to not respond or not answer, block they ass. On the flip side, don't you be calling them. Don't text them. Don't email them either. When it's late at night and it's raining and you at home and you lonely and you sad, don't text them. When you see something that reminds you of them, don't text them. Why? You're leaving that space open. Don't. Just don't talk to them. I am the best person to ignore anyone. Like, I'm a Virgo. I can ignore anybody. You can be in my face calling my name and I'll be sitting here looking like, no problem. So ignore them. Don't communicate. The fourth thing is you need to unfollow them on social media. I had to make this a totally separate point because some people will say social media is not a means of communication. It's a social network, but it's a means of socializing. If I don't want to date you, I'm not talking to you, I've decided that this is over, I don't want to see you on my timeline on Instagram. I don't want to see your stories. I don't want to see what you're doing because I don't care what you're doing. I don't want to see your Facebook status. I don't want to see you on Snapchat. I don't want to see you anywhere. You got to unfollow them because it can become obsessive if you don't unfollow them on social media. You can start to be obsessed with what they do. And I say that because just because you don't follow them on social media doesn't mean you can't look at their stuff. So when I say unfollow on social media, that means don't type in their name under search and go look at their page. No, you need to cut it off. No following, no Facebook friends, no nothing. I don't want to see it. Because then when you on Instagram and they post on their story that they're on a date, you're going to get in your feelings and you're going to be inclined to text them to be like, oh, really? You out on a date? Really? That's how you feel? Don't even set yourself up. Like, just don't do it. Y'all, my hand is just doing everything over here because I'm feeling it today, okay? Tip number 5, stop analyzing the past, okay? Girls have a really hard time with playing the whole relationship through their head and highlighting the good parts, the bad parts, the funny parts, just memories in general. You will drive yourself crazy. Don't do that. It's going to be so hard not to think about the relationship. So I'm not saying don't think about it, but don't overanalyze it. You know, don't sit there and be so caught up in how you guys met each other or when you guys went to Paris or nothing for real. You have to ignore the memories. Now, if something reminds you of that person, okay, I get it. But just sitting there with an idle mind and purposely thinking of every single thing that happened in your relationship is not healthy. And it's not a wise decision if you're 100% dedicated to moving on. So that's going to be hard, but try not to just let your mind wander and think of the should-haves, the could-haves, the would-haves, because then you're going to put yourself in a mental space of potential. And we all know what potential gets you. Potential don't get you nowhere, okay? Potential is nothing. It means nothing. It doesn't get you anywhere. So don't even do it to yourself. It's a setup. Number 6, find a hobby. You need to find something to do. If you like reading books, read a book. If you like gardening, go plant some flowers. Me, you like nails, start trying to do your own nails. Start trying to do your own hair. Find a show that you are obsessed with and sit there and binge watch it or just watch it. Find something to do, okay? Find something to do that you like to do. Paint your nails, I don't know, a hobby, whatever you want to do, whatever you enjoy, do that. Find a hobby, get involved in that hobby, and allow yourself to be absorbed with something new. Tip number 7, kind of goes hand in hand with number six, but number seven, stay active. Don't sit in the house and be sad and upset, eating snacks and ice cream and getting fat. Go out, exercise, take a walk around your neighborhood, join the gym, go to the gym, do a workout class, do an at-home workout. Stay active, stay fit, and try to get fine. Because listen, let me tell you something. The glow up after your breakup is something else, okay? If you ain't know, you better ask somebody, because I definitely had a glow up, and I know several women who glowed up after their breakup. Stay active. Get out. Go meet people. Go to a concert. Go to Starbucks. Child, go to Target. Go somewhere. Get out. Get out of the house. Stay active. Work out, run, jump rope. Whatever you can do to keep yourself going and keep your energy up, I encourage you to do that. Tip number eight, spend time with your family and friends. Now's the perfect time to call your girls up and be like, girl, I know I haven't really been myself for the last few months, but what you doing? You trying to slide? Let's go grab a drink. Let's go look. We love Mexican food. Let's go get some margaritas. If you don't financially have the money to go out and spend money, call your friend and be like, girl, what you doing? Nothing? Okay, I'm about to slide. I'm about to come over. What we gonna do? Shit, I don't know. Watch TV? Bake some cookies? I don't know what we gonna do. I just need to be in your presence. Call your mom if you have an older sister or even a younger sister. Call your sister. Hey, Lay, what you doing? Nothing. You want to go see a movie? You want to come to my house? Hey, Leah, what you doing? Nothing. You trying to slide to the mall? Hey, Mom, what you doing? Nothing. Okay, I'm about to just come over and hang out at your house. Just spend more time with your family and friends. Sometimes being in the presence of someone else could make a world of difference. So yeah, take advantage of the time. That's the thing, we think we have the most time, and really time is the most precious thing on earth. So spend time with your family and friends, people who actually matter. Tip number nine, rediscover yourself. If you guys watched one of my videos and I was having a girl chat with y'all, like a girl talk, get ready with me, I told y'all I had to figure out who the hell I was. Figure out who you are. Figure out what you want out of life. You know, you have to rediscover yourself. Okay, I'm gonna do that. That's what I'm gonna do. I don't care what nobody think, I'm gonna do it. Or I'm not doing it. I don't care how many times you ask me and who asked me, I'm not doing it. Figure out who you are. Spend some time with yourself. When you wake up in the morning, after you meditate or spend some time with God or have your spiritual time, have some me time, okay? Sit in the tub, take you a bath with some wine and some music. Do a facial at home, do your nails, do your feet. Just spend some time alone. Rediscover who you are by spending time by yourself. And time by yourself is healthy. It's good to spend time by yourself. I love spending time by myself. I'm like my best friend, okay? So yeah, take advantage of that. Last but definitely not least, tip number 10, talk to a therapist, okay? Talk to a counselor. Talk to a professional. Don't go running your mouth to your old friend from 2 years ago, because that's just gonna open up a can of worms. If your mom is your confidant, talk to your mom. If you have another confidant, talk to that person. So many times in our community, we kind of shy away from mental health. And I work at a mental health organization, or for a mental health organization. And your mental health is important. It's nothing wrong with seeking counseling. It's nothing wrong with having a therapist. It's nothing wrong with just going in for one visit just to get it all out. You don't have to go talk to someone every other week or every month or every week. Sometimes you just need to get it out and move on. If you haven't talked to a therapist or a counselor or your confidant, your best friend, your mom, your grandma, listen, let me tell y'all. Grandmas and granddads, don't even get enough love when it comes to being able to talk to someone. Granted, your mom and your dad, they lived, they know a lot more than you know. But if your grandparents are alive, you're blessed to have your grandparents, they know more than your parents know. I love sitting down with my granddaddy and just talking to him, and he spit some real shit to me. Like, he's so full of wisdom. He might not, you know, say it in the best way, or he might not think it's as big of a deal, but he gonna drop some gems regardless. Oh, he gonna give you some life lessons, and he gonna give you a life lesson in one sentence. He'll tell you straight up, if it's meant to be, it'll come back. And you'll be like, damn, that just made me feel so much better. Sometimes older and wiser people just have the gift of life and time that they can actually offer real advice, and it's genuine, it's real, and it's true. If your mom is your best friend, like my mama is my best friend, run it by her. Sometimes though, parents can be involved with your boyfriend, like they have their own relationship with them that they don't always give the best advice. So obviously your mom is always going to tell you things in your best interest, but she might be a little biased because she actually likes your ex-boyfriend, or she doesn't think what they did is a big deal. Sometimes you just need an unbiased party to give you some advice or just listen. Because listen, an ex-boyfriend or an ex-girlfriend will have you thinking you're crazy. You'll be sitting here like, I'm tripping. Like, am I crazy? Like, I gotta be tripping. It's a setup. I hope that you guys enjoyed this video. Of course, make sure you leave me a thumbs up and a comment down below letting me know how you got over your ex. Make sure you subscribe to my channel. Don't forget to follow me on Instagram. And until next time.